5.3, parity in in-system competition. Consider an out-of-system competitive scenario. This is difficult since almost all vertebrates, social or otherwise, have evolved to have very stylized rules of interaction, even across species. Nevertheless, take the hypothetical situation where an individual is accosted by a mean mugger with a knife in a dark alley. This engagement does not last very long. On the other hand, consider an in-system competition. Perhaps when two sports teams meet on the field or when two males face off in a herd. That can continue for hours. In-system competition favors parity among competitors, since otherwise it is difficult to sustain the intensity and credibility of long competitions. There are weight classes in sports, ranging from boxing to weightlifting. It would be unfair to have boxers, for example, compete across weight classes. In many sports leagues, the teams choose from the new crop of players in reverse order. The team ranked at the bottom of the league in the previous year gets to pick first. Any disparity among competitors obviously favors the better endowed competitor in the short run, but hurts the competition and helps all competitors in the long run. It is extremely boring if the same entity wins every time. Thus, arbitrary rules arise over time to ensure that no single entity can capture all the spoils of an in-system competition, whether in one round or over multiple rounds. The competitive uncertainty about survival is mostly replaced with the uncertainty over which entity will win. In-system competition cannot eliminate all competitive elements. That would be boring. There is little interest in seeing a larger wrestler take on a small one. On the other hand, there is slightly more interest in seeing two wrestlers of the same size, and definitely more interest if this size is at the larger end of the scale. Non-human in-system competition is everywhere around us. Consider two young males from a herd facing off against each other to establish herd hierarchy. Even a small probability of injury or death every time this happened would dramatically weaken the herd and the species. Thus, every in-species competition is an example of in-system competition. Fiddler crabs, deer, bison, birds, humans comparing muscle cars, all of these are examples of in-system competition. Perhaps bacteria, who have means of chemical signaling, also back off hunting a target if it can be identified as kin.